In this video, you're going to learn how we fix Google Merchant Center suspensions. This suspension means that Google doesn't think that your store is trustworthy for one reason or another. When you set up your Google Merchant Center account and you try to run Google Shopping ads, Google gives every single advertiser what's called a risk meter. If you have been suspended for misrepresentation of self or product, then Google has seen you as too risky. It's likely that a multitude of things resulted in your suspension. Often I'll look at stores and I'll tell someone the reason for their suspension and they'll say something like, "But Sam, I saw that my competitor does this too and they're not suspended." Yes, it's because Google uses a risk meter and many things are going to add up to cause your suspension. For example, if you have a fresh domain name, a fresh non-branded email address, a new store, a new Google Ads account, a new Google Merchant Center account, and you make some mistakes, that's going to increase your risk meter and push you over the edge to become suspended. Most of the stores that we audit have a bunch of things causing their suspension, not one single thing. So why does Google suspend stores? Google doesn't want you running Google Shopping ads if they think that you're not going to provide a good user experience to the people searching. This is something that we talk about in the compliance video of our free Google Shopping course. I recommend you check out that website and learning how to make your website fully compliant to avoid Google Merchant Center suspensions. I'll leave a link down below. So how do we fix our suspension? First, we need to find out the cause of the suspension. There's a big list of things you need to fix and check on your store and in your Google Merchant Center account. Once we fix these, we then request a review in Google Merchant Center. We then wait and see if we get approved. If not, we go deeper. We scour everything and see if we can fix the cause of the suspension and try again. So what do we need to check and fix? Okay, we'll go through the big list now. You'll find a link to download this checklist down below. First, your product feed. Fix any disapprovals, errors, and warnings. You see this in your Merchant Center dashboard when you go to products, diagnostics. This should be all clear. You shouldn't have any disapprovals, warnings, or errors. Go through our video on how to fix Google Merchant Center disapprovals. I'll leave a link to that video down below. Next, we want to fix up our business settings. I also have a full video on how to add in your business settings. I'll leave a link to that down below. Let's go through all the things you need to check. First, make sure you add in your company information into the business settings. Make sure this information is accurate and matches the information that's elsewhere on the web. You want to make sure it's consistent with all your social media, your Google My Business account, and any other directory websites. Any inconsistencies here, flag with Google as they think you're lying and misrepresenting your business. Make sure you use a real physical address and make sure your phone number is real and when someone calls, they don't get your mum. Make sure you use a company branded domain email address. This means if your store is coolcandles.com, make sure your email is hello@coolcandles.com and not some sort of Gmail address. Also make sure you have an actual branded domain name, like coolcandles.com. Don't use a Shopify subdomain like coolcandles.myshopify.com. Also make sure that you claim and verify your domain in Google Merchant Center. I have a full video showing you exactly how to do this really easily. I'll leave a link to that down below. Make sure you set the branding colors for your website and brand. And make sure you add both logo sizes in there too. Next, we have our tax settings in Google Merchant Center. Make sure your tax settings are properly set up for your selling location. This is especially true if you're selling to the US, as the tax settings do get a bit complicated. I do have a full video on setting up your tax settings in Google Merchant Center. Go and watch that. I'll leave a link down below. Next, we have our shipping settings in Google Merchant Center. Same as your business information settings, make sure this matches what's actually on your store and how you actually ship your products. If Google spots any inconsistencies here, they're going to suspend you. So go through meticulously what's on your shipping page and how you actually charge for shipping on your checkout. I do have a video on showing you how to set up your shipping settings properly. I'll leave a link to that video down below. Okay, now that we've done our Google Merchant Center account, let's now look at our website. When we've fixed suspensions, there's almost always something that we had to fix on the website. Now, a lot of these things aren't going to be the only thing that causes your suspension, but all these things add up to a higher risk meter for your store. And one of these things could be the straw that broke the camel's back. First, check your website's page load speed. Use the Google Page Speeds Insight tool to see how Google grades your site in terms of speed and check multiple pages. I'll leave a link to this tool down below. Also, make sure there are no broken links across your site. Make sure there are no English mistakes or grammatical issues across your store as well. Also, make sure that you don't have any of this placeholder text or placeholder images. Copying the images that other stores are using can also attribute to your suspension. Google also isn't the biggest fan of dropshippers. If you're selling the same AliExpress product that 10 other dropshippers are also selling with the same title, description, and product images, you are going to have an increased risk of suspension. Google also likes reviews, so if you can get them on your store, that'll be better too. Plus, check the apps and plugins on your store. Only use the apps you actually need. We also like to check the reviews of all the apps we use to see if there are any people talking about getting suspended for using this app. We did have a case where we fixed a suspension where Google didn't like an app the store was using. Google had flagged this app with code as malicious software. We've also seen some apps like upsell apps cause suspensions too, as they're not functioning correctly and the pricing is off at the checkout. So make sure that your website functions exactly as it should, including all the apps and plugins and checkout functionality. Next is a big one, your store's contact information. Google really cares about this because it's a huge marker of trust. Here's what I recommend you implement if you are serious about getting your suspension fixed. First, add your store's physical address listed on your website. Then also add in your customer service telephone number, a number that people like Google could call and get a representative for your business. Make sure that you have a branded email address on your store and not a Gmail address. Then make sure to add the physical address, the phone number, and the email address on your footer and on your Contact Us page. You can also add them to the header of your store, but this is optional. On your Contact Us page, add a contact form. Also add in your business contact hours and an estimated wait time to get a reply from you. Then make sure the contact information on your footer, on your Contact Us page, matches everything elsewhere on the web, including your Google Merchant Center account and your Google Ads account. Lastly, make sure you set up an SSL certificate on your store. If you're using Shopify, this is set up automatically when you set up your custom domain. Also, make sure that the language of your website matches the language of the people that you're targeting. Now that that's done, let's now look at our legal pages. Make sure you have a terms and conditions page and a privacy policy page on your store. Next, make sure they're unique to your website. A lot of people just copy these from other stores and they don't change things like the brand name or the product categories. Make sure that these pages match what you're selling and what you're about. Make sure that the privacy policy page clearly explains how the user's browsing data may be used for your store. Then make sure to add links to these pages in your footer and in your checkout process. Next, let's look at the refunds and returns page. This is huge. Google wants to know what you will do when customers have problems with the products and your store. If you haven't set up a refunds and returns page, go and watch my full video on how to do this. I'll leave a link down below. Here's what your refunds and returns page needs. Clearly indicate the process for requesting a refund or returning an item. Do your customers call you? Do they email you? And how does the refund process work? Make sure you outline the different processes for different circumstances of refunds and returns. Do you offer exchanges, change of mind, or faulty product returns and refunds? What about damaged products or the wrong product? What if the product never arrives? Or what if the customer cancels after ordering? Also include time frames for each circumstance of refund or return. Clearly outline the time it takes to receive the refund. Also indicate the method of return of the refund. Is it with the same credit card the customer used to purchase? Or is it with store credit? Just be clear. Also make it clear what the return period is. For how long after purchasing can a customer return their product? Also make sure the returns and refunds page is in the language of your target customers. Also, very importantly, add a link to the returns and refunds page in your footer, on your product pages, and in your checkout. Next, we have our shipping page. This page tells our customers all about our shipping policies. Make sure it matches what's in your shipping settings in Google Merchant Center. Make sure it matches what the actual shipping process is. Outline the cost of shipping for each geographical location that you ship to. This can even be something like US shipping versus international shipping, That's okay. Also outline the time to ship to each location and the courier service used, like UPS, FedEx, or DHL. Make sure it's also clear how a customer can check the status of their order. Do they receive tracking information, or do they have to contact customer service to find out? I also recommend adding a section for missing items. What if a customer receives their order, but it's missing some products? What happens then? Once that's done, make sure to add a link in your footer, on your product page, and in your checkout process too. Next, we have our branding and homepage structure. This is important. Google wants to see that you're a trustworthy brand. Make sure you have an About Us page that describes the mission and history of your store. This is something that gives transparency to your website. Make sure to add your About Us page and your Contact Us page links to your header navigation. Also add them to your footer. Make sure to add links to your shipping policy page, your returns and refunds page, your terms and conditions page, and your privacy policy page. Make sure to also include contact information in your footer. This includes your email, phone number, and physical address. Next, let's take a look at our product pages. First and foremost, don't make misleading claims. I see a lot of suspended stores making bold claims about their products not backed up by evidence. Google hates this. Make sure your product information is relevant and up to date. This includes the title, description, and images. This also includes the availability of your products. Make sure that your product feed matches what's on your store, especially regarding what's in stock and not in stock. This is very important. Make sure your products aren't dangerous. Google is very careful with health-related products because they can make some bold claims and actually hurt the customer. Another thing to watch out is counterfeit products or products that infringe on trademarks. Also make sure that the product condition, whether it's new or used, is accurate and matches what's in your product feed. Also make sure that your pricing is accurate and matches what's in your feed and what will reflect on your checkout. Next, let's look at the checkout process. Throughout the checkout, you want to make sure that your legal pages are visible. I'm talking about linking your refunds and returns page, your shipping policy page, your terms and conditions page, and your privacy policy page. Make sure that the links to these pages are the same pages that we just set up before. Don't create double pages. Make sure that your contact information is visible throughout the checkout process. We recommend adding the big three: your physical address, a contact phone number, and a branded email address. Make sure that you also have multiple payment methods available and they're also shown in the footer of your store. Make sure the final pricing in the checkout matches what's in your product feed, what's on your product pages, and there are no hidden charges showing up here on the checkout. Also make sure that the shipping costs shown here on checkout match what's in your Google Merchant Center account and what's on your shipping policy page on your store. Next, we want to make sure that any Merchant Center promotions that you've set up in Google Merchant Center are accurate and reflected on your checkout. Finally, just double check that your SSL certificate is working on your checkout. Okay, let's now look at misleading information. Don't claim to be a certified reseller when you're not. Don't use trust stamps on your website without the proper affiliation. Don't make false statements or claims about who you are, your qualifications, or your products. Once you've fixed up these issues, we then do some final checks before requesting our review. Check that your Google Merchant Center account has a product feed submitted. Google requires that all accounts have a product feed with at least one product in order to review. Without the feed, the request a review button won't be available. So if you do get suspended, don't just delete the feed. Now, once you've fixed all the issues, it's now time to request a review. This is pretty easy. Just log into your Google Merchant Center account, look for the bar that shows the suspension, and click request a review. It takes a few days, sometimes up to a week, to be reviewed. If you request a review and you get denied, you're going to be put in a waiting period. Use this time to find the cause of your suspension and fix it. Keep trying. Don't give up. You want to be sure that you fixed every potential cause of your suspension before requesting a review again. Too many denied requests can result in a permanent suspension, which you really don't want. Here are my final tips with dealing with a Google Merchant Center suspension. Don't try to outsmart Google, game the system, or get around Google's policies. You will lose. They'll catch you eventually and you'll just get a permanent suspension and you'll never be able to run ads ever again. Never try to create a second Google Merchant Center account. You will get suspended immediately as soon as you try to claim and verify the URL. This isn't Facebook. You can only have one Google Merchant Center account per domain. Don't give up. A lot of people try to fix their suspension and give up after their first attempt. A lot of suspensions that we've fixed take multiple tries. Keep scouring Google's policies, scouring your store, trying to find the cause, fixing it, and then requesting a review. Now, this video here is actually part of our free Google Shopping course on our website. It shows you how to set up, optimize, and scale your Google Shopping campaigns. I'll leave a link to it down below. I recommend checking it out once you fix your suspension. If this video was helpful, please give it a like and let me know in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.